Welcome to a video on graphing quadratic functions in standard form. In a previous video, we graphed quadratic functions in general form, or the form of f of x equals ax squared plus bx plus c, so we should know that the graph of this is a parabola. But if we take general form and we complete the square on the right side, we'll have standard form that looks like this, where f of x is equal to a times the quantity x minus h squared plus k. And what's nice about standard form is we can tell a lot about the graph just by looking at the form of the function, where if a is positive or greater than 0, the parabola opens up, and if it's negative or less than 0, it opens down. Also, the vertex of the parabola occurs at the point hk, and the vertical line passing through the vertex is the axis of the parabola, or axis of symmetry. One of the things we have to be very careful about is identifying the correct sign of the x and y coordinates of the vertex, which are identified by h and k, but it has to be in the form of the quantity x minus h squared plus k. So what that means is, if we had x minus h, we'd use a positive value for h, and if it was x plus h, we'd use a negative value of h. However, for k, if it's plus k, we use a positive k. If it's minus k, we're going to use a negative value for k. So for example, if we have y equals the quantity x minus 3 squared minus 1, the x coordinate of the vertex would be positive 3, and the y coordinate would be negative 1. So you can think that the x coordinate is the opposite of what you see, but the y coordinate is exactly the same. So if we have y equals the quantity x plus 3 squared plus 5, the x coordinate would be negative 3 in this case, but the y coordinate would be positive 5. The real reason why this is negative 3 is because it actually has to be written in the form of x minus h squared. So technically it's x minus a negative 3 squared plus 5. But as you already know, we normally write minus a negative as plus a positive. So we should be very careful when we're identifying the signs of the x and y coordinates for the vertex. Let's go and take a look at a graph of a quadratic function in standard form. What we're going to do here is leave h and k equal to 0 and change the value of a. Notice when a is equal to 1, the parabola opens up. As we increase the value of a, it still opens up, but it is stretched vertically. As we decrease the value of a, it is stretched horizontally, but as soon as a is negative, the parabola opens downward. Let's go ahead and put the value of a back to 1. And change the value of h. Remember, h is the x-coordinate of the vertex, so as you might expect, changing the value of h shifts the parabola left or right. Notice that when h is positive 4.7, the equation is in the form of x minus 4.7. And when h is negative, the equation is in the form x plus the value, because we're really subtracting a negative. Let's see what happens when we change k. Remember, k is the y-coordinate of the vertex, so if we increase k, it shifts the parabola up. If we decrease k, or if k is negative, the parabola is shifted downward. Let's go ahead and take a look at a couple examples. Let's say we want to graph this quadratic function by finding the vertex, axis of symmetry, and the intercepts. Well, we should be able to tell that the value of a would be 1, so that tells us the parabola opens up. Next, hk would be the coordinates of the vertex, so the value of h would be positive 3, and the value of k would be negative 4. So we have 3, negative 4 for the vertex. Remember, the axis of symmetry is a line passing through the vertex, so the equation of the axis must be x equals 3. Again, we found all of this useful information just by looking at the form of the function. Let's go ahead and review how to find the intercepts. Remember, to find the y-intercept, we're supposed to set x equal to 0 and solve for y. So we would have y equals 0 minus 3 squared, that would be negative 3 squared, minus 4. 9 minus 4 would be 5, so the y-intercept would be 0, 5. And then lastly, in order to find the x-intercepts, we're supposed to set y equal to 0 and solve for x. So we would have 0 equals the quantity x minus 3 squared minus 4. So we'd add 4 to both sides, and then square root both sides of the equation. Don't forget the plus or minus. So on the left we have plus or minus 2 equals x minus 3. Add 3 to both sides, we'd have 3 plus or minus 2x. So we have two x-intercepts. The first one would be 3 plus 2, or 5, 0. And the second x-intercept would be 3 minus 2, or 1, 0. That should be plenty of information to make a nice graph. Let's go ahead and sketch it. We'll plot the vertex at 3, negative 4. Let's go ahead and sketch the axis of symmetry in. Next, the y-intercept is 0, 5 here. Now, because we have the axis of symmetry, we know there must be a mirror image of this point 3 units to the right of the axis of symmetry here. And that'll be helpful. And then lastly, we have our two x-intercepts, 5, 0 and 1, 0. Again, that looks good because they're symmetrical across the axis of symmetry. So now we can just make a nice parabola passing through these 5 points. Let's go ahead and try another one. Okay, we notice that it's in standard form. A is equal to negative 2, so this parabola opens downward. The vertex is hk, so since we have x plus 1, the x-coordinate would be negative 1, and we have plus 8 on the end, so the y-coordinate would be 8. And therefore, the equation of the axis must be x equals negative 1. Now, it doesn't ask us to find the x and y intercepts, it just says find at least two additional points. I'm going to go ahead and at least find the y-intercept. So to find the y-intercept, we set x equal to 0 and solve for y. We'd have y equals negative 2 times the quantity of 0 plus 1 squared, that would be 1 squared, plus 8. So it'd be negative 2 plus 8, that would be 6. So our y-intercept would be 0, 6. Let's go ahead and sketch this information and see what we have. Vertex is negative 1, 8. Axis of symmetry is the vertical line passing through that point. We have the y-intercept of 0, 6 here. There must be a mirror image of this point 1 unit to the left of the axis of symmetry there. And we do have some good information to make a nice graph, but let's go ahead and find the x-intercepts again just to review. Remember, to find the x-intercepts, we set y equal to 0, so we'd have 0 equals negative 2 times the quantity x plus 1 squared plus 8. So we're going to subtract 8 and then divide by negative 2. That would give us 4 equals the quantity x plus 1 squared. Now we square root both sides of the equation. We have our plus or minus there. Looks like we have plus or minus 2 equals x plus 1. So we subtract 1 on both sides. We have negative 1 plus or minus 2. So the first x-intercept would be negative 1 plus 2, that would be 1, 0. And the second intercept would be negative 1 minus 2, that would be negative 3, 0. So we were pretty fortunate here, these came out very nice. Let's go ahead and plot those and complete our graph. We have 1, 0. Notice this 2 units to the right of the axis. And negative 3, 0 is 2 units to the left of the axis, which is a good indication that we're doing this correctly. Let's go ahead and sketch our graph. And there it is. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.